Everything all the way up.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Can you hear me? Oh, here we go. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much. We're so happy to present to you the first annual, and not, there'll be more coming after this, the all-band concert. So we designed tonight's concert to be a showcase of the instrumental talents we have in this district, and you're going to see a lot of talents. We're going to open up with a little fanfare to get things started, then we're going to start right at the beginning age, all the way up to the high school level. Not only is today the first all-band concert I've ever had or had in a long time here, we brought a very special guest in with us. At the December concert, the high school concert, I told you about a wonderful composer that the high school has been working with and loving his music, and we commissioned his work to do something with the band this year, and I can't believe it's already now. And we'll talk more about that later when I come back with the full ensemble. But to kick things off in spirits of Mr. Rossano Galanti, we thought we'd do a little fanfare of his, and we thought, hey, let's have him conduct it too. So it's not in your program that way. So you'll hear more from him, but please welcome to the stage Mr. Rossano Galanti. All right, thank you guys. Make sure your folders and stuff. You can take this. All right, thank you very much. All right, thank you very much. The next we'll bring out Ms. Sarasani in her fourth grade ensemble. And while they're making their way, I'll just remind you of a few things. This is a lot of hard work went into this concert. The kids are so excited to play all this great music for you. So just make sure, if you haven't done so already, to silence your cell phones, put any of those devices that make any kind of extraneous noises away, so the performers are focused and you can enjoy all their great music. So at this time, Ms. Sarasani and her fourth grade band. Thank you.
Our pieces are a little bit shorter than the other ones, so unfortunately. But I'm really excited about for our two bands tonight from the elementary school, because usually we play a concert in December and then we're waiting until May to play. Never do we usually try to pull one together again in March. So this was a lot of hard work that they put into it. Short pieces, but wait till May rolls around. We've started band arrangements, and they are so excited to be able to play those for you already. Our next piece is London Bridge. This one is set up as a duet, so we'll have the upper winds playing the melody, but then a harmony part is going to be played by the low brass. So let's see if you can hear that in London Bridge.
Thank you.
Our last piece for you already, sorry, short but sweet, is a Mozart melody. We won't tell you, there's three other names that we could come up with. And if you can understand from those little ones out there from Elmo, he called it the Alpha Baba Twinkle Song. So see if you can figure out what the three songs are.
Thank you. Our next section is Air of Nobility by James Swearingen. Through the ages, music has played an important role in ceremonies and events to honor individuals or groups. Air of Nobility, with its majestic opening statement, was originally created to honor the many musicians on the stage who sincerely appreciate your attendance at today's performance. We musicians want to dedicate Air of Nobility to Mr. Nelson Beard.
Thank you. Hi, thanks for coming. I apologize. I totally forgot to introduce, and this is not in the program, so you wouldn't know. So this piece that we're playing now, Whirligigs, is actually a three-movement piece. That was the first one, and if you couldn't tell, it was about a marching soldier. These are all kind of stories about toys. So the second one is called Flower Lady. It's very relaxing and nice to listen to. Don't fall asleep. It's so pretty. And the last one is The Flying Horse. So you don't have to clap between movements. So we'll just get on with the program, and you can clap at the end.
Thank you.
So thanks for coming. We just have a couple things to set up, and then we'll be moving on to Shadows Unleashed, our closer. So I just wanted to kind of introduce our band to you. It's a combination of 7th and 8th graders, so I'm going to step aside. And, band, I would like you to stand. If you are a first-year player, if you just started this year, raise your hand. I think we only have one or two. Thank you. And they've really come a long way, so it's pretty impressive. Okay, any second-year players, raise your hand or stand up. Okay, any third-year players? Any four-year players? Okay. And I'm assuming we don't have any five-year players, right? Four is the most. So we've got quite the combination in here. We've got first years, we've got fourth years, which, you know, it can be a challenge, but they rise to the occasion and they really bring their A game. So I've enjoyed working with them this year. They've been a lot of fun. So, and we're hoping to do the summer band again too, so.
Okay, we're almost there. Now for the spot. I've been waiting all year for this, and the kids have been too. So we already met the maestro. The greatest thing about this is that the kids have the opportunity to work with a living composer. We play so much music of, unfortunately, dead people that we can't talk to them, ask them questions, and what did you mean about this? But now we have the opportunity to do so, and not many schools in the world have this opportunity. So we're so blessed. The school is so supportive of what we're doing to bring this wonderful composer with us. So before I introduce him, I just want to give a side note about Whispers, and he'll hopefully say a few notes about that, the piece that he's going to conduct with the kids. Whispers, from my perspective, from beyond, is all about celebrating life, and he says that too in his score notes. And unfortunately, we lost a beloved teacher recently, so we want to celebrate his life, and I know he loved music, and he would want us to celebrate all the great things that have happened. So this piece is dedicated to somebody else when he originally wrote it, and he'll tell you about it. But we want to think about Mr. Nelson Beard and our thoughts, and we're listening to this beautiful, beautiful music. So without further ado, please welcome Maestro Rossano Galanti. Stand up. I have to give you the microphone.
It's on mute.
Thank you. Before I talk about Whispers from Beyond.
Oh, you guys can sit down.
Oh, yeah. Sit down, please. Relax. First of all, I am so honored to be here and working with these fine musicians behind me. We had a blast yesterday. I worked them very hard, and they responded very well. So how about a quick round of applause for these people?
Excuse me. Yes.
Yes, I want to thank the Salamanca High School for the commission. I want to thank them for bringing me out here and treating me so beautifully. And I want to thank, of course, Maestro Bean. Thank you so much. It's been a great experience for me. I think it's fantastic that this school has such a strong music program. You have no idea how important it is to have arts in the school. I was lucky. We had a great music program in my school, which led me to my career as a musician. What would have happened if that was not available to me? It's something important to think about. So, before I conduct Whispers from Beyond, I want to tell you a little bit about it. Last year, it was a commission from a school in Star Point High School near Grand Island. And the conductor and I had a mutual friend. Her name was Cheryl Williams Jenicky. She's a musician, a flute player, teacher. And she had a battle with cancer for 8 years, and she did pass away last year. And they thought it would be nice for me to write a piece for them. And of course, I said yes immediately. And when I compose, it's not easy for me. It does not come easy to me. But when I was asked to do this commission for her, the music oozed out of me at the piano, and I wrote it very fast. And loss is hard, and it is part of life. And it was an honor to write this piece for her. It's not a sad piece at all. It's a joyous piece. It's a celebration of her life. Thank you very much.
Okay. Now the part I've been waiting for a very long time is to introduce the River Seneca to the world. And you guys are going to be the first audience to hear it. How's everyone doing so far? Everyone's all right? I don't have any candy to drop from the ceiling or any guests coming in off of a bus or anything, but I do have some River Seneca water coming to a park near you very soon. So, pure river water. Anyways, a little bit about this piece while I'm getting the kids. It's a quick break. Make sure you guys are drinking your river water. You're all good. When we first talked about this piece, we wanted to evoke a spirit of this community. This community has such a wonderful spirit, has a charm to it. And what really brings this community together and the livelihood of this community is the beautiful river. It supplies us with everything, emotionally, you know, physically, things like that. So this beautiful piece is, to me, is like an enchanting journey down this river. We see different things, we hear different things, and we just overall just have a beautiful spirit of our wonderful community and the people. A quick little nod to our beloved composer, Ray Evans. We have a little jingle bell in the middle of the piece, kind of a silver bell, a little tribute to him. So now people know that, and hopefully soon, this piece will be played by bands worldwide. And if you go on YouTube and you look up this composer's music, you'll find playlists and bands and countless community groups, colleges, playing his music. This is a rare treat for us to have him here. So, please, please enjoy the River Seneca. Thank you. Wow. Woo. So at this time, I also want to thank the dedication to the music staff here. Ms. Lungershausen and Ms. Irsani, they played with us and they helped the kids and they encouraged them and they gave them lessons because they knew what a triumphant effort this is all going to be. So thank you very much to those, and Mr. Kemitzer and the rest of our music staff, Mr. Cornell at Prospect. We appreciate them, all their work. Again, thank you, Mr. Galanti. That is just, and that piece is going places. You're going to, again, a couple years, it takes a while for things to get published, but in a few years, you're going to be on YouTube, type in the River Seneca, and it's going to be everywhere. People are going to put out images, and they're going to, but we'll be the first ones on there, I promise. So how do you follow up something like that? Well, you really can't. Quick little story, I'm giving them a little break. One of Galanti's great admirers, he always wanted, he told me, he said, I always wanted to be John Williams, but I never turned out to be John Williams, but I'm fine with that because I'm doing what I love and people love what I do and we're happy he's doing what he's doing. But he still loves John Williams, we love John Williams. The first piece that this band ever played of Mr. Galanti's was Mount Everest. And he's not ashamed that people say this. Some of the kids say, you know what, Mr. Bean, this sounds familiar. I'm like, what are you talking about? It sounds like Jurassic Park. I say, you know what? Oh, okay, I can hear some of those motives in there. So put this whole puzzle together and somehow a way to cap an already awesome performance in an evening, we decided to put a little Jurassic Park theme in the end. This will get some time for, are you staying? Yeah. Oh, okay, I thought you were gonna go take care. So what happens, wait a second. Megan,
what?
It's your turn.
No, it's after,
you want me to do it? No, okay, we'll do it in the transition, because what's gonna happen after Jurassic Park is gonna bring in all the kids of the Salamanca instruments, and we're gonna have like 130 people playing at one time, and it's gonna be awesome. So here's Jurassic Park. It gave the kids enough break downtime. So enjoy Jurassic Park. Think of the big dinosaurs or whatever you want. Thank you. the spotlight, don't they? But we love them. So we're going to start transitioning into our next phase of the evening. Where do they go? There he is.
On behalf of all the seniors, we would just like to thank both you and Galanti very much for what you guys have done. It's truly been inspiring for me. I actually went home and I watched a lot of Galanti's videos on YouTube. I think the band, you're definitely improving this music department, and I'm so grateful for everything that you've done personally. Galanti, I thank you for accepting the commission wherever you are.
He's coming.
Oh, there he is. Thank you both very much from the bottom of my heart and from the whole band.
Well, thank you. And thank you to everyone else. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you, guys. Thank you. Thank you. Hey. Thank you. Thank you very much. This is not expected. We do what we do because we love kids and we love music. That's what it's about. It's about the kids and the music. Okay, sorry. we're going to get set up for the next piece, and I'll be right back with you.
All right, so you guys find your spots.
Percussion, remember our jobs? What? Oh, just sit down. All right, while they're filling in, just do me a favor, audience members, you just kind of keep out of the aisles, especially when we finish this piece, let the kids get out first, so because they have a lot of expensive instruments. Not that we can't use more, but we gotta be very careful. I just wanna do a couple thank yous so we can end the concert on a great note without me yapping some more. I wanna thank the administration, the students, and most importantly, I wanna thank the parents, the grandparents, the community members, the caregivers, everyone who supports the kids playing music. So thank you very much. Our goal is to make this tradition bigger and bigger every year. We want more kids to be involved. We want more parents to be involved. We want to make this 200 plus kids, 300 plus kids. We will go wherever it takes, and we'll put kids wherever we can in this auditorium to make this the biggest combined piece we can do. That's okay. Hey, tenor saxes, you can actually probably move up if you don't have enough room, just so you know.
are just about almost ready. What I do want you to do, or what I do want you to do, I want you to brag. I want you to brag on social media how great we are and then how wonderful this community is. So brag to everyone and let them know what we're doing down here, and we need to do more of this. So not now, listen, and then go home. Twitter, tweet it, and do whatever you gotta do. So I selected the golden baton, so I have the pleasure of being the head of my show, but I would be remiss if I didn't add over there. Here they are, they're gonna come up the aisles and help the sides here. So this is pretty cool. All right, here we go. Everyone ready? All right, tap along. Please sit. Let the kids get out first because we have a lot of instruments. Have a safe drive home, and we'll see you back in May for our next set of concerts. We have a musical coming up in March, and spread the good news about what we're doing. You're all great. Thank you.